example in our backyard, because we can do the same. It's essentially saying, you know, that if you are getting involved, if you're going to continue to fund Ukraine in the war in Ukraine, if you're going to continue to back our enemies, we will do the same with yours, and they're only 90 miles off your coast. So I think that is the global context in which it's taking place and why it's happening now. And of course, that does send a sort of an echo of the Cold War, but Americans have been, American officials have been very careful to say they do not perceive this in any way as a threat to the United States, although of course they are monitoring it.
I think they've been playing it down, haven't they? Well, do you think this tells us more about the health of Russia's relationship with Cuba and Latin America than it does Washington?
Yeah, I do. I think basically what it says at the moment, in many ways, is that the U.S. has taken its eye off the ball in the Americas, not just Cuba and the Caribbean, but across the region. The next place that these warships are expected to go would be Cuba's socialist ally, Venezuela. And let's not forget that the last time we saw ships coming in, or one of the last times we saw ships coming into Havana Bay, they were U.S. cruise ships coming in, and this sense of detente, this sense of a new future between the old enemies during the Obama administration. All of that was cancelled under President Trump. So the change, if you like, for observers in Havana to watch, you know, the same stretch of water where those cruise ships came in with this sense of kind of a new